Welcome to another part of partnership. Today we are going to study a new topic, that is guarantee of profit to a partner. What is this guarantee? We are going to study this in detail. When a new partner is admitted into a partnership, the existing partners will assure to the new partner that he should be paid a certain amount of money as minimum amount of guaranteed profit. That is, when there are two or three partners in a firm and a new partner is entered into or is admitted into the partnership, the existing partners will say that whatever may be the profit of that firm, we will give you a fixed amount as, or we will give you a minimum amount as profit. That guarantee or that assurance or surety is known as guarantee of profit to a partner. Okay. It means an assurance to give a minimum amount of profit to a partner irrespective of the firm's actual profit. That is, whatever may be the profit, or if the profit is not there, if it is a loss also, that minimum amount of guaranteed amount should be given by the existing partner to the new partner. That assurance or surety given by the existing partner to the new partner is known as guarantee of minimum profit. So even if there is loss also, the existing partner should give that amount. Even if there is no profit or profit falls short of the guaranteed minimum amount, the newly admitted partner enjoys the privilege of getting the guaranteed profit. In the first part of partnership, we studied about the types of partners, isn't it? So there was a type where partner in profits only. What is the speciality of that partner? That partner will enjoy only the profits and he will not be liable for the losses. So that type of partners comes to guarantee of minimum profit. So here it says that even if there is no profit, that is if there is loss also, the guaranteed amount should be given to the new partner, or profit falls short of the guaranteed minimum amount. That is, if the guaranteed amount is less than the profit of that year to be given to that partner, then also this amount should be given. That is, it is a surety that that amount should be paid to that particular partner. If the profit falls short means if there is any shortage or if there is any deficiency, then the guaranteed minimum amount should be given to the newly admitted partner. The newly admitted partner will enjoy the privilege of getting the guaranteed profit even if there is loss also. Okay. So this is the speciality of a guaranteed partner. We can understand this through an example. That is, Kiran is admitted into a partnership with 1/4 share in the future profit subject to a minimum of Rs. 30,000. If Kiran's share of profit falls short of Rs. 30,000, as per assurance, he will be given the guaranteed minimum of Rs. 30,000. His profit is guaranteed for a specified amount. That is, here Kiran is the new partner. When Kiran enters into the partnership, the existing partners of the firm says that we will give you an amount of 30,000 even if there is loss. That is, the minimum guaranteed amount here is 30,000. So when loss occurs also, the existing partners are liable to pay this 30,000 to Kiran, because this is the guaranteed amount. If Kiran's share of profit falls short of 30,000, that is, if the profit of that year which is to be distributed to Kiran is 20,000, that is, which is not 30,000, if it is below 30,000, that is, if it is 20,000, he will be given the guaranteed minimum of 30,000. Then also, the other partners should give the rest of the amount, that is, the 10,000 amount. The guaranteed amount is 30,000 and the profit is 20,000, then that there is a shortage of 10,000, isn't it? That 10,000 should be given by the partners who assured it. Okay, that is, his profit get guaranteed for a specified amount. This process is known as guaranteed of minimum profit. Have you understood this? അതായത് മൂന്ന് പാർട്ട്നേഴ്സ് ഉള്ള ഒരു പാർട്ട്നർഷിപ്പ് ഫേമിലേക്ക് ഒരു പാർട്ട്ണർ എൻ്റർ ചെയ്യുകയാണ്. അപ്പോൾ ഈ പാർട്ട്ണർ വരുമ്പോൾ തന്നെ പറയും, ഒരു മിനിമം ഗ്യാരണ്ടീഡ് എമൗണ്ട് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് പ്രോഫിറ്റ് ഇല്ലെങ്കിലും ഞങ്ങൾ തരാമെന്ന് എക്സിസ്റ്റിംഗ് പാർട്ട്നേഴ്സ് അഷ്വർ ചെയ്യുകയാണ്, ഉറപ്പ് നൽകുകയാണ്. ആ ഒരു പ്രോസസ്സിനെയാണ് ഗ്യാരണ്ടീഡ് പ്രോഫിറ്റ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. ഓക്കെ, അപ്പോൾ അതിൽ എത്രയാണോ ഷോർട്ടേജ് വരുന്നത്, ആ ഒരു ഷോർട്ടേജ് എമൗണ്ട് ആരാണോ അഷ്വർ ചെയ്തത്, ഏത് പാർട്ട്ണറാണോ അഷ്വർ ചെയ്തത്, ആ ഒരു പാർട്ട്ണർ കൊടുക്കണം. ഓക്കെ, സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് ഗ്യാരണ്ടീഡ് പ്രോഫിറ്റ്. നൗ ഹു ഇസ് എ ഗ്യാരണ്ടീഡ് പാർട്ട്ണർ? That is, we know that a partner to whom guarantee of minimum profit has been provided. That is, who is the incoming partner or who is the admitted partner? That partner who benefits the guarantee of minimum profit, that partner is known as guaranteed partner. That is, those partner who receives the minimum guaranteed profit, that partner is known as guaranteed partner. That is the incoming partner who receives the minimum amount. Now, who is the guaranteeing partner or guaranteeing partners? The partners who have given guarantee of minimum profit, that is, which are the partners who gives that minimum profit, that partners are known as guaranteeing. So if A, B, C are the three partners in the firm, that is the existing partners, that partners gives assurance to Mr. D, who is admitted. So here A, B and C are the guaranteeing partners, and D, who receives that amount, that person is the guaranteed partner. Now, what is a guaranteed amount? The guaranteed amount means the minimum amount for which guarantee is given. That particular amount, because in the previous example, 30,000. 30,000 is the guaranteed amount which is given to the incoming partner. So that amount is known as guaranteed amount. The person who receives that benefit is known as guaranteed partner, and the persons or the partners who gives that assurance is known as guaranteeing partners. Clear? Next, who can provide guarantee and in what ratio? We said that the existing partners can guarantee to the incoming partner, isn't it? So either one partner or all of the partners can guarantee to the incoming partner. That is, if three partners are there, three partners can say that, okay, we three can divide that and we can share that minimum amount of profit which is to be given to D. Otherwise, A says that only I will pay that amount and you persons are not liable to pay that amount. They will say like that. So either one partner or all of the partners can guarantee the amount. And now the next question is, in what ratio it should be shared? That is, they can share that in the profit sharing ratio, or they can share in the new agreed ratio. That is, if the profit sharing ratio is equal, then the partners can say that, okay, then we will share it equally. Or otherwise in a new ratio, that is 3/4 will be shared by one person and 1/4 by other person. That is, it's up to their decision. So they can share that agreed portion, or they can share that guaranteed amount either in the profit sharing ratio or in the agreed ratio, that is in the new ratio. Next is the different types of guarantee. There are two types of guarantee: personal guarantee and firm guarantee. Personal guarantee means when an existing partner guarantees to the incoming partner to pay that minimum amount of money in an agreed ratio. That is, if A and B says that we will pay that assured amount and C need not pay. So here it is a new agreement or new agreed ratio is there. So that type of guarantee is known as personal guarantee. That ratio will not be the mutual profit sharing ratio. It will be an agreed ratio. That is, it will be a new ratio. That is personal guarantee. Next is firm guarantee. Firm guarantee means when the guarantee is given by all partners in the existing profit sharing ratio. That is, if the profit sharing ratio is equal, that is 1:1:1, that is A, B and C share it equally, and those three persons agree that they will share that the minimum amount equally, then that is the firm guarantee. Here there will be no agreed ratio. It will, that ratio will be the mutual profit sharing ratio. So when the existing partners assures to the incoming partner to pay that amount in an agreed ratio, it is personal guarantee. And when all the partners in that firm agrees to share that amount in an profit sharing ratio or in the mutual profit sharing ratio, it is known as firm guarantee. Okay. Now, we know that there will be a minimum amount to pay that incoming partner, but when the profit is distributed, there is a shortage or there is a deficiency. So that deficiency can be calculated by how we know that the guaranteed profit minus the share of profit available will be that shortage amount. That is, what is that guaranteed amount and what is that profit? The guaranteed amount minus the profit which is available to the incoming partner, that amount is known as deficiency. And sometimes there can be surplus. That is, the guaranteed amount is 30,000 and the profit may be 40,000. So what is there? There will be a surplus there. No, 10,000 is surplus. So share of profit, if share of profit available is more than the guaranteed amount, it is surplus. The accounting treatment for guarantee of profit. First, the firm will distribute the amount to the existing partners and the incoming partner. The incoming partner's profit should be calculated. So the existing partner's profit is distributed, and if the incoming partner's amount of profit is less than the minimum amount of capital, then that amount should be given by the existing partners to the incoming partner. That is, we said that there are four partners in a firm, A, B, C and D. D is the incoming partner. So first the firm will distribute the amount of capital to A, B and C. Now check that D's capital is less than the minimum amount. Here the minimum amount is 30,000. So if the profit is 20,000, that is the share of profit to D is 20,000, then this 20,000 should be given by these three partners, that is A, B and C. Okay, that is the concept. So the second point is, if share of profit falls short, or if there is a deficient, or if there is a shortage of amount, it should be met by the existing partners in an agreed ratio. That is, the partners say that, that is, if A says that half of the portion I will give and the rest half you should share it. That is, B and C should share the rest half of it. So in an agreed ratio, the existing partners bond means adjust that deficiency. Okay, the fourth step is deduct the deficient amount from the partners concerned and add all these amount with the guaranteed partners profit. The deficient should be met, half of the deficient amount should be met by A. That is, here the deficient amount is 10,000, that is 30,000 minus 20,000. 30,000 the minimum amount and 20,000 the profit which is to be given to D. So there is a shortage of 10,000. That 10,000 should be met by A. That is, A agreed that half will be given by A and the rest of the half, that is 5,000, will be given by A and the rest of the 5,000 should be shared by B and C. So the A's share, from the A's share 5,000 will be deducted, and from B's share 2,500 and C's share 2,500 will be deducted, and the rest of the amount will be each partner's profit and D's share will be 30,000. So you understood the concept. If there is adequate profit, until here we discussed about the deficiency. Now if there is a profit which is more than 30,000 or which is more than the minimum assured amount, then actual share of profit to the guaranteed partner is more than the guaranteed amount, then he is entitled to receive the actual share of profit. That is, here the minimum amount is 30,000 and the profit which after distributing D get profit 40,000, then D will get that 40,000, because here only assurance is given that if the amount is less than that profit only, we will give the minimum amount, and if it is more than the assured profit, then you will get that amount. Understood? Now let us look through an example. First question, that is to identify which type of guarantee. We said that there are two types of guarantee. It is a personal guarantee and a firm guarantee. Personal guarantee means when the existing partners share the minimum profit in an agreed ratio or in a new ratio, it is known as personal guarantee. And a firm guarantee means all the partners share it in the mutual profit sharing ratio, that is in their old ratio itself. That is firm guarantee. Now let us look which type of guarantee this is. Pen, pencil and book are equal partners. Book has guaranteed a minimum amount of rupees 4,000. If there is a shortfall, then it will be taken by pen and pencil as follows. That is, here the new partner is book, and book is guaranteed a minimum amount of 4,000. That is, if loss occurs also, pen and pencil said that we will give you a minimum profit of 4,000. So, if a shortfall means if a deficiency or if a shortage occurs, it will be taken by pen and pencil as follows. That is, there is a condition in it. That is, the first condition is pen and pencil has agreed ratio 5:3. These are the three conditions or these are the three questions for you. The first question is pen and pencil will agree that 4000 or will share that 4000 in a new ratio called 5:3. That is, if the profit is less than 4000, then pen and pencil have to share that profit. And in which ratio? 5:3. That is, here pen has to give 5/8 and pencil has to give that 3/8 portion of that deficient amount. Okay. So, which type of guarantee this it will be? This will be a personal guarantee because the existing partners share the minimum amount as agreed ratio. So, this is a personal guarantee. The second condition, by pen only for the deficient amount. That is, here pen only have to pay and pencil need not pay. So, which type of guarantee this will be? This will be also a personal guarantee because the existing partner shares that in an agreed ratio. Here the ratio is changed, so it will be a new ratio. It is a personal guarantee. Now the next, by pen and pencil as per mutual profit sharing ratio 1:1. That is, here they share it equally. So what is a firm guarantee? A firm guarantee means when all the partners share the minimum amount in the mutual profit sharing ratio. So this is a firm guarantee. Okay, the question is identify the type of guarantee in the above cases. So the answer is, the first case it will be a personal guarantee, second case also personal guarantee, and in the third case pen and pencil both agree in their old ratio, so it is a firm guarantee. So you understood the difference. Now next is a demonstration problem. Tony and David are partners. On 1st April 2017, they admit Joseph with a guaranteed amount of ₹10,000 as per partnership deed. The profits for the year 2017 to 2018 amounted to ₹15,000. The new profit sharing ratio between the partners are 2:2:6. Prepare profit and loss appropriation account in the following cases. That is, here also the condition is, if burden of shortfall contributed by Tony and David as per the agreed ratio 2:3, it is a personal guarantee, and by Tony alone for all the deficient, by Tony and David as per mutual profit sharing ratio 2:2:6, it is a firm guarantee. So here we are required to prepare the profit and loss appropriation account in the following cases. We know that here two partners were there. Tony and David were the partners and Joseph was admitted into the partnership. So when Joseph was admitted into the partnership, Tony and David said that you will get a minimum amount of guaranteed amount, that is 10,000 as share of profit. So that year the profit was 15,000 and the new profit sharing ratio between the partners was 2:2:6, and three conditions are given. That is, the minimum amount here is 10,000, and if minimum guaranteed amount is less than that, the share of profit, then what will be the condition and what will be, how will we solve it? First condition is, by Tony and David as per agreed ratio 2:3. So we know that it is a personal guarantee because the existing partners share the minimum amount of guaranteed profit in the agreed ratio, that is in the new ratio. Okay, so how will we calculate in this case? Let us look. Computation of the net profit available to partners after adjustment of the minimum guarantee. Okay. We know that the new ratio is 2:2:6, isn't it? So, there are three partners, Tony, David and the new partner, Joseph. So, the new ratio is 2:2:6, that is, each partner's share will be 2/10 and 6/10. Next, we know that the minimum amount which is assured to Joseph is 10,000. So, while admitting Joseph, it gives a minimum guaranteed profit as 10,000. Share of profit of partners. For each partners, what will be their share of profit? We said that that year the profit was 15,000. So, that 15,000 should be distributed to the partners in their profit sharing ratio. So, Tony's share of profit will be that 15,000 into what is his share 2 by 10. So 15,000 into 2 by 10, we will get 3,000. And also David's share is 2 by 10, so same 3,000. And Joseph's share is 15,000 into 6 by 10, that is 9,000. Okay, now the share of profit is distributed to the partner. Now we have to check whether Joseph have got the minimum amount of capital, minimum amount of profit that he is assured. Joseph was assured 10,000. That is, Tony and David said that your minimum amount of profit will be 10,000. Whatever may be the condition of the business, or if there is loss also, you will get 10,000. But here, what is the amount that Joseph got? Joseph got only 9,000. So there is a deficient, or there is a shortage of the fund. Deficiency to Joseph is 10,000 minus 9,000 is how much? 1,000. So now what we have to do? The Tony and David want to distribute their assured amount to Joseph. So what is the new ratio that are they agreed that the first condition is by Tony and David as agreed ratio 2:3. And David said that if such deficiency occurs, then they will share that in the ratio 2:3. This is the agreed ratio. So this 1,000 or this deficiency should be shared by Tony and David. So 1,000 into 2/5 is Tony's share, and 1,000 into 3/5 is the amount which David should pay to Joseph. Okay, so the net profit. So now Tony had 3,000, and from 3,000 Tony paid 400 to Joseph, and David had 3,000, and from 3,000 David paid 600 to Joseph. So now Joseph got 10,000, that is the minimum assured amount. Now what will be the share of profit of Tony? That is 3,000 minus 400 that he given to Joseph, the amount will be 2,600. And David, he paid 600 to Joseph, and 3,000 minus 600, it will be 2,400. And Joseph got the assured amount of 10,000. So this is the concept. It is a very easy concept. Okay, this is the guarantee of profit which is given to the incoming partner. How will we prepare the profit and loss appropriation account? We know that the net profit which is available to the partners are distributed through an account called a profit and loss appropriation account. So here the net profit is 15,000. This 15,000 is distributed to the three partners. That calculation we did now. So Tony got 2,600, David got 2,400, and the new partner Joseph got 10,000. That is the assured amount. Okay, so this is profit and loss appropriation account. Now the second case, what is the second case? Tony alone will bear all the deficiency. That is, Tony said that if any shortage occurs, I will bear it, or I will give it. So from Tony's amount, Tony had the profit 3,000, and from 3,000 the deficient amount 1,000 is deducted, and his share will be 2,000, and all the others will be same. That is, here only Tony have to bear the deficiency. Okay, that was the condition. So here only this will change, Tony's amount only will change. Okay, next is the third condition, that is Tony and David share it in a mutual profit sharing ratio, that is their old ratio, that is a firm guarantee. In firm guarantee, how will we calculate? We know that the deficient amount is 1,000, and the agreement is this 1,000 should be shared equally. That is, Tony and David should share that amount equally. So Tony's capital is 3,000, deficient amount 1,000. That 1,000 is split into two. 500 should be paid by Tony and 500 should be paid by David. So 3,000 minus 500, 2,500. And David also 3,000 minus 500, it will be 2,500. And the rest will be same. Joseph will get the assured amount. Only this will change. Okay. So this is the third condition. Now let us look at another question. P and Q were partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio of 5:3. On April 2014, they admitted R as a new partner for 1/8 share of the profit with a guaranteed amount 75,000. The new profit sharing ratio between P and Q will remain the same, but they agree to hear any deficiency on account of guarantee to R in the ratio 3:2. The profit of the firm for the year ended 31st March 2015 was 4 lakh. Prepare profit and loss appropriation account of P, Q and R for the year ended 31st March 2015. Here there are two partners. P and Q are the partners and R is admitted into the partnership. So P and Q's old ratio was 5:3 and when R was admitted into the partnership, his 1/8 share and his guaranteed amount is 75,000 and the new profit sharing ratio will be the same, but they agreed that if any deficiency occurs, then they will share that in the ratio 3:2. So the profit was 4 lakh. We are required to prepare the profit and loss appropriation account. The first step is we want to calculate the new ratio. What is the new ratio? In the question, new ratio is not given. Okay. That is only said that they agree. The new profit sharing ratio between P and Q will remain the same, but they agree to bear the deficiency in the ratio 3:2 only. So we don't know the new ratio, that is P, Q and R, what will be the new ratio. We will calculate it. The new ratio, share of the new partner is 1/8. No, R is the new partner. R's share of profit is 1/8. Okay, so if it is 1/8, then the remaining share will be 1 minus 1/8, because there are 8 portion and in that 8 portion, only 1 portion is R's share of profit. So remaining there will be 7 share. No, so remaining there will be 7 share. So the remaining share is 7/8. Now P's share, we know that 3 partners. P's share is 7/8 × 5/8, because in the question it is said that P and Q were partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio 5:3. So P's share, P's, how can we calculate P's share? P's new share, because the remaining share is 7 × 8. In that 7 × 8, P's share is 5/8. So P's share will be 35/64. And Q's share, it will be, the remaining portion is 7/8. And in that 7/8, only 3/8 is Q's share. So that will be 21/64. And now R's share, we know that 1/8. It can be calculated, can be taken evenly. So it is 8/64. So thus the new share will be 35:21:8. Here we calculated the new ratio. It is given in the question that P and Q were calculating it as 5:3. That was their previous share and our share was 1/8. So we wanted to know what is the new profit sharing ratio. So for that, the R share was 1/8, so we know that only one portion is R's and the remaining will be other partners' share. So we want to calculate each partner's share of profit. First we calculated P's share. We know that the remaining partner's share is 7/8 and P's share is 5, that is 5:3, so P's share will be 5/8. And from this 7/8, only 5/8 is P's share. So it will be 35/64 and Q's share is 3/8. So it is 21/64. So R's share is 1/8. It is converted into that form, that is 8/64. So the new profit sharing ratio is 35:21:8. Okay, this is how we calculate the new profit sharing ratio. Now, the second step, we are supposed to prepare the profit and loss appropriation account. We know that profit and loss appropriation account is the amount which is given to the partner. Now we want to calculate the share of profit. So first we want to calculate what amount is distributed to each partner. We know that the profit is 4 lakh, isn't it? This 4 lakh is divided into these three partners P, Q and R in their ratio 35:21:8. So P will get how much? 2,18,750. Q will get this 1,31,250 and R will get 50,000. Okay, that is 40,000 × 35/64 is P's share of profit and Q will be 4 lakh into 21 divided by 64, that is 1,31,250. That is Q's share of profit, and R will get 50,000, that is 4 lakh into 8 divided by 64. That is the amount that they will get. Now we have to look whether R has got the minimum amount. R has got only 50,000, isn't it? So there is a shortage of how much? 25,000. There is a shortage of 25,000, that is 75,000 minus 50,000, there will be a shortage. So that shortage should be met by P and Q. So from this amount, that is from 2,18,750, what is their new ratio? 3:2 is their agreed ratio. That is, if deficiency occurs, P will have to pay 3/5 and Q will have to pay 2/5 of that deficient amount. So from 2,18,750, that deficient amount, that is, the deficient amount is 25,000. 25,000 into what will be the rate? 3/5, that will be 15,000. So this is the actual amount of, or actual profit of P. From this, the P should pay the minimum amount, that is the 15,000. That 15,000 is the deficient amount. Deficient amount is 25,000. 25,000 into new ratio, that is 3:2. So deficient amount, that 25,000 into 3/5 is 15,000. That amount should be given to R. Then P's share of profit will be 2,03,750. Okay, you understood this. Likewise, Q. Q's actual profit is 4 lakh into 21 divided by 64. That is 1,31,250 is Q's actual profit. From this profit, Q agreed that if any deficiency occurs, 2/5 will be given by me. So here Q will have to pay the deficient amounts 2/5 portion. The deficient amount is 25,000. So that 25,000 into 2/5 is 10,000. This 10,000 Q should pay to R. Okay. So the amount 1,31,250 minus 10,000 is Q's share of profit, that is 1,21,250. And now R's profit is 50,000, that is 4 lakh into 8 by 64 is R's share of profit. His guaranteed amount was 75,000. So this 75,000 was given by the remaining deficient amount, that is the 15,000 and 10,000, that is 25,000, was given by these two partners. So R got the guaranteed amount 75,000. Hope you understood this concept. Next question is, Kiran, Laiju are partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio 2:1. They admitted Mohan with 1/4 share in the future profits with a guaranteed amount of 50,000. Kiran undertook to meet the liability arising out of the guaranteed amount to Mohan. Profit sharing ratio between them agreed to be 2:1:1. The firm made a profit of 1,52,000 for the year ended 31st December 2015. Prepare profit and loss appropriation account showing the distribution of profit among the partners. So here there are two partners, Kiran and Laiju, and they admitted one more partner to their firm known as Mohan, and his new share was 1/4 of the future profit. And the guaranteed amount is 50,000. That is, Kiran and Laiju said that if loss occurs also, we will give you 50,000. Now, Kiran undertook to meet the liability arising the guaranteed amount to Mohan. Okay, Kiran said to Mohan that if such a deficient or if such a shortage occurs, then I will pay the amount. Kiran said that I will take the responsibility. The profit sharing ratio between them is 2:1:1. That is, new profit sharing ratio will be 2:1:1. The firm made a profit 52,000 for the year ended. So we are required to prepare the profit and loss appropriation account showing the distribution of the profit. So how can we calculate this? Here we know that the profit sharing ratio is 2:1:1 and the profit of that firm is 1,52,000. So first you prepare roughly that what will be the profit of each partner. We know that Kiran's capital will be 2/4 into 1,52,000, that is 76,000, and next partner Laiju's capital will be 4, that is 1 by 4, it will be 38,000, and the new partner Mohan's will be also 38,000. So here Mohan's assured amount is 50,000. So there is a deficiency of 12,000. This 12,000 should be met by the partner Kiran. That is the condition. If the deficiency occurs, Kiran has to pay. So this 12,000 should be paid by Kiran. So from Kiran's amount, that is from 76,000, this deficient amount 12,000 should be deducted. Okay, so it will be, the amount will be 64,000. Okay, and that amount will be given to Mohan. So Mohan's capital amount was 38,000. Add to that amount 12,000, the deficient amount, Mohan will get 50,000. So this is the profit and loss appropriation account. Okay, first you have to prepare a working note, and from that working note you have to write Kiran's capital, this much amount, 64,000, and next Liju's capital, 38,000, and Mohan's capital, 50,000. All the rest you should be you have to write in the working note, otherwise you will get confusion. Okay, so in today's class we discussed about the minimum amount that is to be guaranteed to a new partner or an incoming partner. Hope you understood today's class. If you have any doubt, you can contact me. Thank you for watching. Bye.